Just a few moments ago, President Trump arrived at the White House back from a meeting of NATO leaders in London. Over the course of the three-day trip, the BBC reports that Britain's prime minister would only meet with President Trump off camera and on camera face-to-face. France's president appeared to castigate the president on ISIS and NATO as they sat side by side. The trip ended abruptly after Canada's prime minister was caught on a hot mic talking about President Trump to other world leaders. Mr. Trump canceled a planned news conference and left London. Take a look. The person you heard talking about President Trump's team's jaws dropping to the floor was Canada's prime minister, Justin Trudeau. President Trump was asked about those comments this morning. Here's what he said.
Did you have a video of Prime Minister Trudeau talking about you last night?
Well, he's two-faced.
Do you think that Germany's too naive?
And honestly, with Trudeau, he's a nice guy. I find him to be a very nice guy.
And right after that, he canceled his planned press conference, boarded Air Force One, and took off. He's back at the White House now, where CNN senior White House correspondent Pamela Brown is as well. So Justin Trudeau, according to the president, is both two-faced, also a very nice guy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right. According to the president, two-faced, nice guy. Those two things don't necessarily go together. Of course, these two leaders have had a very rocky relationship from the beginning. And I'm told by a source familiar who has recently spoken to the president that he was annoyed and bothered by that exchange that you just played there, that hot mic moment where Justin Trudeau seems to be mocking the president, laughing about the press conference, a lengthy press conference he had there. And so that really seemed to bother the president. But this source said that these two men will probably work through it as they work through other issues in the past. But it certainly, Anderson, is something that was just another layer to this rocky NATO trip for the president in London. As you pointed out, he also had some strong words for French President Macron over comments he had made about NATO, saying they're brain dead. And then the ISIS fighters' comments saying that he should take on more ISIS fighters. There's tension with those two. And then, of course, this interaction with Trudeau. And for Trudeau's part, he has not walked back what we saw in that video. In fact, he talked about it and made light of it, saying that, yes, the president did hold this impromptu press conference before they met and that it was notable, but he didn't apologize or express any regret publicly. What remains to be seen here, what we don't know about is privately whether the two men have spoken, Anderson.
It's interesting because, you know, President Trump has, over the course of several years, often said, you know, countries used to be laughing at us, they used to be laughing at us, and that seems to be a kind of a recurring refrain of his, and that they're not laughing anymore. Obviously, this video, you know, they're not laughing in that particular moment, but they are laughing in their grouping. That would seem to belie his, you know, or at least feed into his concerns that people are laughing at him. How much did the video, do we know, have to do with the decision to cancel the press conference and fly away?
Well, it certainly seems based on timing that it would have had some sort of impact on the president to make that decision. Now, I did speak to someone tonight who's familiar with the situation, who has spoken with the president, who said actually that the president made that decision on his own, that it didn't have to do with that video in particular, because the president felt like he had already given so much time to the press. He had the press conference, of course, before Macron and Trudeau. He had had many press availabilities, so this person seemed to suggest that it didn't play a role. But it is hard to believe that if the president had seen that before he made that decision, Anderson, that did not get under his skin to call it off. And we should also note that this was all happening during the hearing in Washington today with the Judiciary Committee. And we're told that the president did watch some of that on his flight from Air Force One back here to Washington, Anderson.
We've got to start with this hot mic moment that shook up the summit. Let's listen to that. Catherine, you say it's not that they were laughing at him, it's what they were laughing at him about.
Well, I think it's both, to be clear. Trump's greatest fear seems to be that he will be laughed at. He's talked about how the world is laughing at us something like 50 times before he took office. Clearly, they were laughing at him. He doesn't like that. But it's also the subject matter of this mockery or apparent mockery. You had them talking about three of the most sensitive things in Trump land, right? One is his failing businesses. They talked about the Doral, where he was planning to have the G7 summit next year. They talked about his very transparent and inept corruption, also relating to the Doral, and the fact that he lost that opportunity, apparently, to enrich himself at taxpayer expense. And they also talked about the fact, essentially, that his underlings don't respect him. And if they had just thrown in, you know, a joke about his hand size or something, you know, this would have been a quadruple play. But instead, they got three of the four subjects that he
said. Also, I took it as they were saying how much he loved the cameras because he had a press conference that, right, and that he loved the spotlight and the attention.
Obviously. But all politicians love the cameras, so I'm not sure that he would be particularly offended by that critique.
Well, but I think the president's love is the greatest love of all. So he loves it more than anybody else.
Why do you say this proves that he's a pariah among people who are, should be, among our allies?
Well, look, he has stomped around the world insulting people and threatening them. These are the two things that he does. Or if he might bribe you as well. So there are three things that he does. This has made him, I think, not only a pariah in the civilized world, he's almost an outcast, especially among America's allies. So the first thing he does when he gets into office is trash NATO. Mm-hmm. Then he goes around to every gathering of world leaders and favors the strongmen and the tyrants. So I think people don't respect him. They respect the power he represents. But even that, I think, is less and less.
Do you think they put up with him?
Oh, of course
because
they put up with him.
When you see them again for when they have to do the photo op and they sit there, it just seems like they're just like, okay.
He is the kid no one invites to their birthday party because he's a bully and he is a braggart.
Yeah. Ed, let's bring you in now because our Pamela Brown is also reporting. Sources expect the two leaders to work through this, but this was the president this morning. Listen to this.
Does he have a video of Prime Minister Trudeau talking about you last night?
Well, he's two-faced.
Do you think that Germany's too naive?
And honestly, with Trudeau, he's a nice guy. I find him to be a very nice guy. But, you know, the truth is that I called him out on the fact that he's not paying 2%. And I guess he's not very happy about it.
Sources are telling CNN that Trudeau spoke to Trump this morning and that he gave context but didn't apologize. How are people in Canada reacting to this?
Well, it's kind of complicated the way people in Canada react to this because on the one hand, Canada is a very small country next to a really dominant United States and is dependent on the United States in a lot of ways. And so because of that, Canadians like sort of shows of independence. In the past, when Justin Trudeau's father was the prime minister and Richard Nixon called him an expletive that starts with an A, and he responded, you know, I've been called worse by better people, that became sort of part of his legend. He was widely respected for that. So people like these kind of tweaking shows of independence. But on the other hand, for exactly the same reasons, it's not good to have the president of the United States angry at you. So there's kind of mixed reaction in Canada, and you can see that on social media. You can see that in talk radio and in newspaper columns, where some people are saying, you know, good for Trudeau. This is a mockable guy. He holds a 40-minute press conference largely on his impeachment scandal and domestic issues while you're sitting right there. Of course you're going to sort of have a laugh about it afterwards. But on the other hand, there's a sense of, like, don't poke the bear, right? We're in the middle of negotiating the new NAFTA. This is a thin-skinned, impulsive, and vengeful president, and who knows what he could do next, right? We need the United States as an ally, is the sense in Canada. But so there's sort of a cheering section, and yet there's also a real fear of, you know, what retaliation might come if Trump feels angered by this, if it doesn't sort of go away and get smoothed over.